Each team is required to have two crews of paramedics on scene, as well as an emergency action plan and several AEDs. Now, that leaves the Patriots here. Should anything happen here, prepared.
You could tell it was something more significant than a routine, you know, arm or leg fracture.
Foxborough Fire Chief Michael Kelleher watched in horror like the rest of us as Buffalo Bills safety DeMar Hamlin collapsed on the field during Monday Night Football. The 24-year-old going into cardiac arrest as paramedics rushed to save his life.
So this would be an example of the cardiac monitor that they would have.
For home Patriots games, his team of paramedics works in partnership with private EMS companies, along with trainers and doctors from the Patriots, to train routinely for all sorts of scenarios, including cardiac events. He says whether in the stands or on the field, having a medical emergency in a stadium provides some of the highest chances of survival.
All of our firefighters that are on detail up there are paramedics. There are paramedics from coastal ambulance on the field, and then the doctors and trainers from the team. You know, some of the best in the business, so I think they should have a high degree of confidence.
Very similar situation happened to my son.
A similar situation, but a different outcome for 16-year-old Michael Elcazar of Sutton, who suffered cardiac arrest on the football field back in 2010.
No ambulance, no AED at the field. It took 15 minutes for it to arrive, and 15 minutes is too long. Mike passed on the football field that day.
His family helped pass Michael's law to help improve access to defibrillators at sporting events and in general. Chief Kelleher says that AED was likely crucial in saving Hamlin's life.
I don't think we would do anything different here.
Now, the Patriots also tweeting tonight, "Our hearts are with you, number three," in reference to DeMar Hamlin. Tonight, he remains in critical condition. We're live inside Gillette Stadium tonight. I'm Peter Eliopoulos, WCVB.